Hi, we're the Insiders, and you're watching Walnut TV. Is because it's the choice, it's the style of music that I love, the way that I can express myself. I can do it best, I think, through ska, and I like the rhythms that go with it. I like the horns, the brass that goes with it. So even if I wasn't playing music and still doing that, like I said, not a day goes by that I don't listen to some sort of ska band or style. You guys, why do you guys play ska? Why were we able to rope you into the band?
I used to love the band. When I was like in high school, the Insiders were like one of my favorite groups. So now it's totally crazy that, you know, 10 years down the road, I'm like in one of my favorite bands. But I used to like love ska, I used to love Supertones, love Five Iron. Like, there's a ska maniacs who are aware the Insiders, Five Iron, and Supertones are playing. Those are both years. I love it. It's still like one of my favorite shows. And so now,
yep.
So now, like, it's just, it's awesome, like, pouring into that, and, you know, it's also, like, a little nostalgic for me, but I do love it, man. It's just so much fun.
You know, ska, unfortunately, was just part of a wave of popularity, and not a day goes by that I don't listen to it on, you know, headphones or anything, you know, something like that. I always have ska going, but I realized for the rest of the world, it ran its course. And, you know, you just kind of get caught up in that, and when it crashes, it crashes, and it crashed. And, you know, we just kind of saw the writing on the wall, took a step back, you know, got married, got real jobs, you know, things like that. And then I think enough time goes by that you kind of feel that creative urge to do something again. And, you know, we kind of started talking about it and got some people together and you know, kind of started doing it again. My favorite ska band, I love the Mighty Mighty Bosstones. The Bosstones got me into ska. I was a sophomore in high school when I heard my first Bosstones song, and I was hooked. By the end of the day, I returned pop cans. I did what it took. And what that means is in Michigan, where we are, you know, you return pop cans, you get money for them. And I got enough pop cans to go out and buy the cassette tape of the Bosstones. I was hooked. But my favorite band is a band that's broke up. It was from Chicago called Slapstick. And I think that was the first band that I heard that the singer sounded like me. And so growing up, I knew if I sang, I didn't sound like them, and so I thought I could never be a singer. And then I heard Dickie Barrett from the Bosstones, and I heard Brendan from Slapstick, and I was like, wow, they sing like me, you know, or I sing like them, and I can do something. Like, a band can work if you don't sing like Whitney Houston, you know?
Dude, I just want people to have fun, you know? Like, that's one of the things that I've loved about ska music in general, that just, like, it lets you just open up, just be goofy, be fun, like rock out, skank a little bit, you know, just like have laughs. You know, I just want people to come to the show and just enjoy it. You know, since like ska kind of like waved its way out, like now you go to a show, everyone's just standing there, you know, and like that's what's cool to do these days, you know. And like back in the day, man, people were dancing, people were jumping, people were clapping, and like, that's what I feel like shows should be about, and that's what I miss the most about shows, so.
Yeah, I mean, fun is definitely a big part of it. I think for me, it's just, I want to leave a show and I want kids to think, you know, whether they like the music or not, I want them to be able to say, you know, those guys are being used. And just like I just said, I'm 33 years old, there's nothing special about me. I work for the Salvation Army. I'm a part-time police officer. There's nothing special about me. And if I can leave and one kid can say, you know what, if he can do that, you know, if he can be bold and preach the word of Christ or be able to sing about those things in his life that were so tough and that there was hope in Christ, that's what I want the kids to leave knowing. Because I think in music today, that's the thing. Like, bands like Slipknot, and that's the one that comes to mind right now. Like, those are bands that appeal to kids that are lost. And those kids buy those albums, and they listen to them, and they connect with them because they're like, these guys are going through what I'm going through. But then there's no hope by the end of the album. So this kid is connecting with somebody about going through all this trouble in their life, and the CD ends, and that's all they're left with. So they buy the next CD, and oh, they still connect with me, they still connect with me, and there's nothing. And I think when you dig into their, I mean, they're not too deep, but when you dig into Insider's lyrics, you find hope, you know, and I think that's the thing that everyone's looking for. And so that's what I kind of wish. I hope that when people leave, they say, yes, it was fun, but also, like, those guys did what they were asked to do by God, and they see that hope, or they feel that hope, or they experience that in one of our shows. And just thank you. Thank you for even taking the time to interview us, and you know, if anybody even clicked on YouTube to watch this video, we just thank you for even wanting to hear what we say, and God bless you guys. And we ratchet.